From cost and effectiveness to the potential impacts on the environment. Stay tuned to number one to hear both sides of the pipeline, pros and cons. Number 10, effectiveness. Starting off with a pro, throughout the ages, the most important aspect of economy was effectiveness. Commerce is dependent on the speed of delivery. Without it, there is no economic system. And this is precisely why pipelines are important for today's economy. They make the transport of liquid and gas products much easier and faster. I mean, trains are fast as well, but they have their limitations. For example, a train needs to stop every now and then. Plus, there's the cost of personnel and the cost of running the train. And this cost is a lot of money. Pipelines, on the other hand, require much less in maintenance and manpower. Plus, they are faster because there is a constant flow of product and no train stops along the way. In the long run, the amount of time and money saved through pipelines is staggering. And in the end, the economic benefits are passed on to you, the end consumer. Number 9, construction cost. And now for our first con. Pipelines are great once they're made, but to make them is no easy feat. In reality, pipelines cost a lot of money, and it's not that easy to actually build them. First of all, there's the planning bit. A company needs to find a suitable route and check the terrain, making sure that everything is up to industrial standards. Then there is the cost of the workforce and materials, which can be a lot, especially if the work lasts for a longer period of time, which it oftentimes does. And finally, there's the cost of safety precautions and maintenance, which adds up to the overall price. In the end, the pipeline has to pay for itself relatively quickly in order to make it worth doing. This is one of the main reasons, if not the main reason, we don't have more pipelines around today. There would most likely be more if the cost of making one wasn't so high. Number 8, infrastructure. Before we talk about the next pro of pipelines, we definitely want to ask you to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to click that little notification bell too. We cannot talk about the transport of goods and materials without mentioning infrastructure. Infrastructure is the lifeline of any economy. For example, once the American Railroad was completed, it completely transformed the nation's economy because it became a new integral part of America's infrastructure. And this is precisely why pipelines are great for economy. They are their own infrastructure. Other means of transport, such as trucks and trains, depend on their own lines of transport, such as highways and tracks, respectively. Ships and boats, on the other hand, are limited by bodies of water and weather conditions. Also, the specific terrain can be a big problem, since you cannot build a road or a railroad anywhere you want. But pipelines don't have any of these problems, because they can be laid in all kinds of terrain, and they won't be affected by bad weather. They can even be placed underwater. Certainly, there are limitations, but they are fewer when compared to other means of transport. Number 7, no flexibility. Pipelines are good for different kinds of terrains, and they are used a lot. But there is still a problem with their flexibility. A highway's route can be modified to accommodate changes. A railroad can be displaced too if need be, but this is very hard to do with pipelines. Once a pipeline is laid down, it's practically fixed. This can be a big problem, especially when it turns out that the pipeline route is not that profitable. And this has happened more times than you think. The tricky part is the actual construction. Once the pipelines are laid down, they are fixed and cannot be moved. Well, they can be, but the process is very complicated and very expensive. The situation is even worse if the pipeline goes underground. In that case, the actual relocation process is dreadful. Just imagine the work that has to be done in order to dig up the earth, pull the pipes out, and relocate them. A very serious investment with a lot of risk involved. Number 6, ideal for liquids and gases. It's hard to find a better means of transport for liquids and gases than pipelines. First of all, pipelines are a controlled environment, which means that the health and disaster risks are much lower. Then, there's the shape. The shape of a pipeline is perfect for oil and other such materials, which is why they grew in popularity of use throughout the decades. If other materials were to be transported in such a way, maybe pipelines wouldn't be so popular. But exploitation of liquids and gases has made them absolutely necessary. Pipelines also beat other means of transport because they can be used to separate the natural gas liquids like butane, propane, and ethane from the raw natural gas product and allow it to be transported to the processing refinery. This route from the gas well directly to the refinery is what makes pipelines irreplaceable. Number 5. Fixed capacity and positioning. This drawback is very similar to the previous one. Once the pipeline is laid down, its capacity cannot be increased. What does this mean? Well, it's simple really. The pipes have a certain size and diameter, and obviously cannot be changed. If wider pipes are needed after a pipeline has been made, it obviously can be done. Well, again, it can be done, but the cost would be enormous. To be honest, a lot of research and calculations goes into the actual planning before any work takes place, but there's still a lot of risk. Furthermore, there's a problem of using pipes that are not too small, but too big. This is especially tricky when pipelines are laid close to roads and highways, or in heavily populated urban areas. When a road is being repaired or some part of infrastructure is being changed, very often pipelines get damaged in the process. This, of course, happens completely by accident, but it has happened time and time again. Any kind of activity involving excavation is a potential risk to pipelines. Number 4. Advanced maintenance. Among other things, pipelines are cost-effective because they require little maintenance. For example, if we're talking about natural gas, along every pipeline route, there are little things called compressor stations. These stations are positioned every 40 to 100 miles, and they use large, extremely powerful compressors to press gas further and move it towards the refinery. This gas travels at approximately 25 miles an hour through the pipeline. The amazing thing is that the entire pipeline network is covered with sensors that monitor every aspect of the process. The staff members along the pipeline route can measure the pressure, flow, speed, and temperature. All of the information gathered is transferred further on to the control room, usually via fiber optic feeds, but also by satellite. In addition to this, all parts of the equipment within a pipeline are carefully inspected on a regular basis. Even a single crack or malfunction can be detected on the spot. Number 3. Spillage and repair cost. Now, spillage doesn't happen that often. In fact, it's very rare given all the variables that come into play. After all, companies are investing a lot in safety precautions, improving constantly year by year. But a spillage still can happen, and when it does, it can cost a company a lot of money. You might think that the biggest cost is for damage control and repair, however, it's for something else entirely. The biggest cost goes into damage repair and possible lawsuits, especially if the spillage happened on an area of special importance. Companies dread the potential scenario of having to pay the insurance after a spillage, but they have to do it. And there are many factors that determine the actual cost of insurance, such as the size of the spill, the age of the pipeline at the moment of the spill, the location of the spill, the type of material transported in the pipeline, the amount of loss that happened in the spill, the weather conditions a given pipeline is exposed to, and much, much more. Once the spillage takes place, the pipeline needs to be repaired, and the cost of this can also be quite a bit. Number 2. Increased safety and nature protection. The pipeline industry is very good when it comes to safety regulations because there is regular training provided for all pipeline workers. Thus, the workers learn all about the implementation of new technologies, but they also expand their knowledge on safety precautions and emergency procedures. In the pipeline industry, there is a so-called safety mindset, which means that everyone, from the company's president all the way to the last worker down the ladder, has a built-in mindset for keeping work safety a priority. And not only that, but there's a lot of attention dedicated to the protection of the environment. The routes chosen are those with the least detrimental impact, and after the construction of a pipeline, the area is brought back to its original state. The detrimental impact of construction is also minimized because, during the actual construction, numerous environmental experts are consulted frequently. Finally, a protection plan is created just in case to protect vegetation and surrounding areas. Number 1. No broader use. For our final con, pipelines are, in a way, very limited. Many consider this their biggest drawback because it cannot be applied to all kinds of materials. If we compare them to other means of transportation previously mentioned in this video, we can see that highways and railroads can and do have a much broader use. All kinds of materials can be transported via trucks and trains, from livestock to logging material. And if we include ships, the list can literally go on forever. In fact, the majority of the world's trade is still done via ships. because they have the most capacity out of all means of transport currently available. I mean, even planes still have a long way to go before they can compare with ships. But pipelines are definitely limited, in the sense that they are only good for liquids and gases, such as oil and natural gas, to name a few. Although, to be honest, many people question whether this can still be considered a real drawback, because it wouldn't be fair to compare pipelines with other means of transportation. For what they are, pipelines are a fantastic improvement and addition to economic trade, and we might see a time when they do find a broader use. What is your position on the use of pipelines? Let us know in the comments below, and take care.